Hello everyone. Let's take a look at this rotorcraft helicopter questions. A rotor system vertically flying in an environment with the air density 1.225 kilogram per meter cube. The rotorcraft parameter and control input are given. The density 1.25, the rotor radius 5.51, C 0.32, the number of blade 4, UA, that is when the velocity of the aircraft is on hover state, which shows that UA equals 0. A equals 5.50. The rotational speed 34.48 radian per second. Theta equals 10.19. The longitudinal collective pitch, 0. The lateral collective pitch, 0. Now, we are asked to calculate the induced velocity on the rotor disk and the thrust provided by the rotor. Firstly, we need to establish the momentum theory of the rotorcraft. When is in over. T equals 2 rho pi r squared UA plus V1. And VI is induced velocity at the rotor disk. That is the induced velocity at this particular rotor. Or the one given there. So since the rotorcraft is on the hover state, then the UA is going to be 0. Now, using the formula Ct equals 2 Uz plus lambda high, then Ct equals thrust over I r squared. So therefore, 2 lambda I squared plus 2 UZ lambda I minus CT equals 0. So by turning this into quadratic, you can find the lambda to be minus 2 UZ plus or minus 4 U Z squared plus 8 CT all over 4. And if that should be the case,
uz plus or minus uz squared plus 2ct over 2. And don't forget that lambda I has to be positive, so that gives us u z plus u z squared plus 2ct over 2. Now, using the blade element theory, we can establish the theory equation to be Ct equals half rho A theta 0.75 over 3 minus lambda plus uz over 2. And if that should be the case, by substituting this particular equation, that is equation 1, then our Ct equals half sigma A into bracket theta 0.75 over 3 minus uz over 2 minus 1 over 4 uz plus 2ct. Plus 1 over 4 uz. And if that should be the case, it becomes half A theta 0.75 over 3 minus 1 over 4 uz minus half the square root of uz squared over 4 plus ct over 2. Let's assume S equals uz squared over 4 plus ct over 2. Then ct equals 2s squared minus uz squared over 2. Now, let's establish solidity ratio. Now, by establishing the solidity ratio equation for the rotorcraft, which is sigma NBC 4πr. Don't let us forget the number of blade NB is 4. Multiply by C, 0.32. 0.14. 5.51. Which is 0.0740. So our solidity ratio for the rotorcraft equals 0.0740. And don't forget that the slope of lift curve A, which is given to us in the parameters, A equals 5.50 per radians, which is called the slope of lift curve of the rotodynamics. And our theta 0.75 equals the theta naught minus 0.75 k theta t. And don't let us forget that our k theta t equals 0.00 degree. So therefore, our theta naught, which is given, equals 10.19 minus 0.75 times 0.0 degree, and this gives us 10.19 degree, which can be calculated to radians to be 10.19. times pi over 180. In radians. And if that should be the case, our theta 0.75 equals 0.1779 radians. Calculator. Now that we have found the theta 0.75 of the rotorcraft blade, we can find the UZ and let us forget that UZ equals UA over rotational speed to the radius, which is 0 meter per second over 34.48 radian per second multiplied by 5.51 meter radius. That is UZ equals 0.34.48 times 5.51 is equal to 0. So therefore UZ equals 0. Now, going back to the equation of the blade element theory, 2s squared minus uz squared over 2 equals half rho a theta 0.75 over 3 minus 1 over 8 sigma e dot uz minus 1 over 4 sigma A X. And this become 2A squared plus sigma A X over 4 minus R Z squared plus 1 over 8 sigma A Uz minus 1 over 6 sigma A times theta 0.75, which equals to 0. And from here, the equation can be simplified to be S squared plus sigma A X over 8 minus bracket Uz over 4 minus 6, 1 over 16 sigma A Uz minus 1 over 12 sigma A theta 0.75 equals 0. And this can be also be simplified further to S plus by slotting all the values. The solidity ratio for 0.5 over 8 x minus the bracket 0 over 4 and the minus 1 over 16 times 0.0740 5.50 all multiplied by 0 minus 1 over 12 multiplied by 0.0740 5.50 multiplied by 0.1779. Equals 0. From here, our equation can be simplified to 0.0509 x minus 0 minus 0.0060 to the 77 x squared plus 0.509 x minus 0.0060 3377. And this can be slotted into Cragg's equation, which will be x equals negative 0.0509 plus or minus 0.0267 2 5 8 9 over 2. X1 equals 0.056 2 9 0 7 0 2 7. And X2 equals negative 0.1071902 7. And this is the positive one. So the root that established the positive one will be chosen. So X equals 0.056 2 9 0 2 7. which is 0.0563. CT equals to 2s squared. When I use s squared 2, now using the truss coefficient theory. That is CT. You can deduce that CT equals 2a squared and I use a squared over 2. And this has been established earlier on. So therefore, by slotting the value, CT becomes 2.0563 square, and with 0 squared over 2, our CT becomes 0.0063339 38. And if that should be the case, now that we have all the parameters, we can calculate the truss. The truss equation, you got the CT, that's the coefficient of truss, the product of density, pi, the radius square over the rotational speed and the radius, all squared, and this and back. And if that should be the case, then the truss becomes 0.0063 1.225 × 10.14 × 5.51² × 34.48 × 5.51² And the truss become 0.0063 × 1.225 × 10.14 × 5.51² equals 26568.52 N. Now the truss being calculated, the next thing is to calculate the induced velocity, which is being applied by the truss. VI. So how do we calculate VI? Let us forget that the equation of the truss will be used. 2 rho pi r squared ua plus vi. A equals 0 due to overstate. So therefore, the equation becomes 2656825 equals 2 times 1.225 times 3.14 times 5.51 squared 0 plus VI. So VI equals 10.66 meter per second calculated. So therefore, the thrust equals 2659569 newton, and the induced velocity equals 10.66 meter per second. Thank you for staying tuned.